much longer than that because it does get very dark and it's not very good. And we won't be making any food stops, but this is Georgia and you will never study this country. I think I know you. Welcome. Johan? Philip. Welcome, Philip. Okay. So, you can never study this country. You can always grab something from one of the street food stands. Plus, I have a feeling that we will try something delicious anyway. Also, we won't be making any toilet stops. They're also inherited in absolute hell. I cannot recommend any of them. But we will be walking next to a really nice museum. So once we're there, I'm gonna tell you if you feel like you really need to use it or where we can find it. Also, if you need anything, just let me know. We can stop if it does this. So is this your first day here? Everyone does. First day. Yes. Yeah. Well, then I have an important question for you. What do you think? Is Georgia a safe country? Yes, Georgia is actually a very safe country, and according to some statistics, now I personally really don't like statistics, but people ask us. So I know all sorts of statistics. You can always come to me and ask me whatever else you want to know. History, statistics, bunch of them, useful tips you might need. So according to some statistics, Georgia is the third safest country in the world. And that's actually pretty impressive, especially because I will be telling you more about history and it wasn't very safe after the fall of the Soviet Union. So there are still three safe issues that we need to warn you about. Safe issue number one is the traffic. Did you? Yeah. How does that work? Does it work? How do you cross the street? A very touristy answer. Yes, just cross, but still, accidents might happen. They happen a lot. So Georgians are very warm people, very kind people. But once you put it behind the driver's wheel, something you can't forget, and they become killing machines. So basically, they don't respect your issues. You probably noticed that so far. There, however, are rules, are internal rules that everybody uses, whether you're a pedestrian or a driver. The first thing you need to do when you want to cross the street is make eye contact. And I'm actually very serious. It took me 2 weeks before I learned these rules, and now you can cross the bridge, it doesn't matter, they will stop. So first make eye contact. Then you have to show with your posture that you're confident enough to cross the street. That's actually a big thing here. Georgians are very proud. So the posture. And if even that doesn't work, there is one magical gesture that can stop the traffic in the middle of the street. And we will... Hi, welcome, walking tour? Sorry. Perfect, why? We just started. This is Georgia, never late in Georgia. You're actually pretty early. So, okay, I will give you the sheet later if you want to sign, write down your email. I'm gonna send you an email with the information. Okay, welcome. So, I'm gonna ask you questions later on how to cross the street. Thing issue number two are beggars. You also might notice that there's a lot of beggars here, especially in the old town. And I'm not talking about the old ladies wearing all black sitting next to churches, they're fine. I'm talking about really young kids. They are excellent psychologists. And if they see you're hesitant for us and you're going to give them a coin, they will grab your leg and they will not let you go. And this is actually sitting and it's a long tour. So it's really difficult to walk with two kids on your hands. So how do you defend yourself against the kids? Tickle them, they tend to fall. Also, avoid making eye contact, that also might help. And the safety issue number three are dogs. Usually there are some sleeping on the square. And they're not a safety issue at all. They are absolutely wonderful. And a lot of people play with them, they treat them very nicely, they feed them. So once you start petting a dog, he will follow us throughout the city, down to the river, up to the mountain. It doesn't matter, he will be with us for 3 hours. And they don't just accept Kachapuri if you think you can get something like that. No, they're just for us. They're very intelligent and they will actually make you go to the pet shop and then I will lose you. So, after the tour, please go ahead and feed the dogs, play with the dogs, that's what I do every day. But not during the tour. Just avoid eye contact, it will be fun. So basically, it's all about eye contact. Make eye contact with the driver. Don't make eye contact with the kids and don't make eye contact with the dogs. And now you're stuck. So, we can make a circle so that everyone is included, especially the group got bigger. Okay, so are there any free walking tour versions around here? Does everyone know what this works like? So yes, basically I'm not funded by any company or by government. I work purely for you guys, which means for the tips. But it's perfectly acceptable if you don't like the tour, if you think I'm boring, if you think I yell too much, it's perfectly fine to just walk away. But if you do so, please just wave your hand so I don't think you lost and start following you around, okay? Plus, it does look a bit creepy when I start running after. If after 3.5 hours you still think I'm boring, you still don't like the tour, it's perfectly fine to just walk away again. Or you can hug me, you can kiss me, you can tip me, whatever you like. So actually, if there are any solo travelers around here, that's one of the things I love about these walking tours. Again, there are over 300 walking tours in the world right now, free walking tours. And after this, you will definitely not be a solo traveler, trust me. You will always meet new people. Since the group got bigger, wonderful, I can't remember all of your names. So I would appreciate if everyone could tell me the name of the country as well. So I'm gonna start yelling really loud and then you can follow. Serbia!
Russia.
Oh, Serbia. Nice.
Croatia.
Ah, but
no.
Croatia! Israel! Germany!
Germany!
Was waiting for that! Germany! Russia! Germany!
Singapore!
Singapore!
No, Philippines!
Philippines!
France! Ah! US! Usually it's more easier to remember where people are from. So, okay, now let's start the actual tour. Does anyone know the name of the square we're standing on right now?
Freedom.
Of course, migration. Although I'm asking really easy questions, let's face it, it was written on the website. So, Freedom Square or Liberty Square, or that was probably Smoitani in Georgian, and no, it's not easy to pronounce that. One of the reasons why it's called Freedom Square is because it used to be a Lenin Square. And instead of this shiny guy on the horse, there used to be a huge Lenin statue showing his way to communism, which is actually. So after the fall of the Soviet Union, they took down the Lenin statue, and for that reason, they forgot to turn around the guy on the horse. So now here comes my second question. Does anyone know who he is? And you can't actually see him because he's still facing communism and not the square. But exactly, St. George, yes. And St. George is one of the reasons why we call Georgia, Georgia. In Georgia, it has nothing to do with this word. It's actually Sakartvelo, which means from the Kartvelian region. But they love St. George so much that they have two St. George days a year. And another statistic, last year, 22.6 of all baby boys born last year were named Georgi. Or one of the versions, Gogo, Gaga, Goga, Yevas, it's all nicknames. So 22.6 baby boys. And there is an animal name, it's a female name, and it's Nino. So if you have been here for more than like 5 hours, you probably met some Georgian Nino. Nino was a woman who came from Cappadocia in 4th century and brought Christianity. And they're very proud to be one of the first Christian countries in the world, and they decided to respect their state in such a way, by naming kids after them. So again, last year, 26% of all baby girls were named Nina. And I'm sure you will meet a bunch of Nina, Nina, Nini, Nina. It's all just Nina. Ninos and Georgis while you stay here. So this was actually a small digression. I have a lot of time. Before this was a Lenin Square or a Freedom Square, it wasn't a square at all. It was something called Karavansaray. And it's a Turkish word meaning pretty much a shopping mall. So they had over 100 caravanserais all over the city. The biggest one was right here. So Tbilisi was founded in 5th century, that's a long time ago, on the Silk Road leading from China to Europe. And it was a very important destination. So they had a bunch of these shopping malls. And nowadays, in every shopping mall, you have something to do for fun. You have cafes, you have skating rinks, you have cinemas. Back then, they had gardens and pools, and also the first opera house in the whole province was built right here. And it was all expensive, 500,000 golden rubles. But I mentioned the Georgians are moral people, and sometimes they're hot. So one night, someone dropped a kerosene lamp, and the whole building burned to the ground. and they really do have props to buy. Another example of that is this building that we're standing in front right now. This used to be the old town hall, and obviously it's no longer a town hall, it's just a bunch of shops because the building is the ground. But for some reason, the city mayor decided to share this building with the local firefighting department. And even the firefighters got there. So the building burned to the ground. And the new city hall is 10 minutes that way. And if you do have some time, I would recommend you go there and just see. It's very, very interesting from the architecture. So now let's go to my